Hello everybody, welcome back to my yoga classes. I took some time to record this class because as I have anticipated in my previous videos, I'm in a new environment, in a new place, and I had to adjust to sounds and noise, and it's a quite noisy area. There are a lot of works outside. They are repairing buildings and roads. So I'm trying to record where, when these noise is less disrupting. I will be practicing and I will record this class with music in the background. So all the noise will be kind of mitigated. I hope so. Let's go into the class because I'm really getting into a moment of the day where everybody's out for a lunch break, so I'm taking this opportunity to record this class since I have been making you wait a very long time for this class to come live on your Patreon account. So today we're gonna continue on our mobility versus flexibility. And a couple of you asked me again what's the difference and if flexibility is something to avoid or something not advised. I'm not claiming flexibility is not a good thing. Mobility is a form of flexibility that goes gradually with your body, which means that you do not force your body into flexibility or into stretching or overstretching your body right away. But mobility creates mobility in your joints, in your ligaments, so that gradually by using your breath and while holding the postures, you can increase your range of mobility of that specific area of the body, and as a consequence, your flexibility will improve. But it's just a more healthy approach versus an approach that just overstretch your entire system, risking to damage it. That's my focus. So last class we focused on the torso and upper body mobility. This class we're gonna work more on our hips and lower body mobility. Okay, so be ready to use your feet, be ready to do some stretching exercise for your hips area, and be ready to use your core a little bit today. As usual, be prepared to practice this class, clear up your space, have a yoga mat or whatever you want to use to practice your yoga. I'm sitting on a pillow. If you like to have a pillow to sit on, grab it. If you need straps or pillows of any other kind, blankets, please go and collect them. I do not use props, but I do understand people sometimes need to use props. So based on the information that you have about yourself, grab your props and get ready to practice. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Inhale again very deeply and exhale. chest, exhale, run the energy down, feel the prana, the chi with your hands, inhale. Touch the floor, anchor your energy into Mother Earth. Bring your hands together, touching your forehead. Feel the sacredness of the earth entering your mind and sitting into your heart. Open your hands to spread your love and compassion of the Great Mother into the universe. Seal the energy, the sacredness of Mother Earth in your cosmic womb or Hara point if you are a man. And lift the energy into your heart and bow with gratitude and appreciation for all the support and guidance you may receive. And relax your hands. We're gonna start by doing some warm-up movements for our joints. I will start from the upper body. Remember that even though we're focusing on different areas, like today we're focusing on the lower body parts, still there is a correspondence with the upper part, so we need to warm up anything is above your waistline. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Let's open up the lungs meridians and the heart. Close your hands, your arms in this position. Turn your palms forward. Inhale. Lift your chest. Lift your chin. Exhale, curve your spine. Close your hands. Flip your palms open. Make sure you are really lifting your chest and stretching your arms back. Your chin is up. This is a Qigong exercise for your lungs and heart. Inhale. Exhale. It's intense, it's not soft. exhale, next time, relax. Close your hands into fist and start to rotate your fist around your wrist. Stretch your hands completely, your fingers out, squeeze, stretch, exhale when you bring in, inhale, one more time. And relax. Shake and interlace your fingers this way. Start to rotate your wrist in this way. Doesn't matter what direction, because we're gonna reverse it. Just breathe long and deep. Reverse it. One at a time, and notice that your chest will automatically move. So allow your chest to move. One side with your shoulders. Change direction. Your shoulders, keep your shoulders relaxed, and in, out, in, out. And the opposite. And shake. Take a moment. These small exercises really lubricate your joints and warm up the ligaments and the muscles by doing very simple exercises. Those are essential if you want to really enjoy your yoga practice. Really prepare the body to more intense movements such as static stretching or dynamic stretching and strengthening exercises, postures. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, take the time to really feel the heat turning on within your body. Become sensitive to the sensations that your body is sending you. Take a deep breath in and let's start warm up the lower part of the body. Bring your right leg in the front. I like to put my hands underneath my knee, but you can put your hands here for this part, but here is better because then we're gonna do some exercise with the knee. Point to your foot, see, like me, like a ballerina, then flex it. Point and touch the floor, flex. Just breathe naturally as you feel. And now point and start to rotate. Rotate in a way that you can feel all articulations of your ankle moving. Remember, when you go down, you fully point your foot. And change direction. Press your knee against the torso, relax, inhale, stretch your spine and bring your knee in, relax. Two more times. Now up here, stretch. Stretch up and stop to rotate. If you had like a knee surgery, this one can be a little bit challenging. Don't do it at all, or if you feel confident, you just do it with a smaller circle. Like this is enough. It's actually very good for the ligaments of the knee, but it's not advised for people that have actually gone under the surgery. Reverse the circle. Relax. Back to the center. Take a moment to feel the difference, how you feel the two legs. And reverse. First, point, flex. Today will be all about feeling the body and taking the time to really activate profound flow of energy. Now point, circle. Change direction. Point. Now stretch, bring knee and torso together, relax. change direction. Center. Relax. Take a deep breath in to feel. And exhale. Let's start with our focus on mobility, and today there will be some dynamic stretching and more on the static stretching, but still I will try to balance both type of stretching and also give some strengthening exercises. Let's move into kneel pose or rock pose for certain yoga tradition. For others is a warrior pose, this one. Keep your spine straight. If you need it, you can open your knees slightly apart, but for now I would like just to go into baby pose, so with your head down to the floor, and I want you to relax your spine. If it's too intense, you can put your pillow in the front, so your forehead will go on the pillow. If for belly issues or belly needs, you need to open slightly your knees, do so. I will do so because it doesn't feel good to have completely the belly pressing against the heart or the chest. Also, if you have a big chest, it's good to open slightly your knees. But do not open it too much, because then we go into the next posture where we need to open the knees a lot. Take a deep breath in. And exhale gently. Bend over. And relax. Your hands down by the side of the body. If you're using the pillow, it looks like this. It's actually very comfortable with the pillow. Just breathe normally and relax everything. Check your posture, there is always some more relaxing to you. Use your breath to check that every single part of your body is relaxed into the posture. Your hands next to your shoulders. Slowly help your torso to return straight. Take a deep breath in, just feel the energy running. As I said before, become sensitive to what the body is telling you. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Now you can open your knees wider apart. Notice that my toes are touching behind it, so they do not open like my knees, only my knees open up. My hands are in the middle, they walk forward and then relax your torso down and your head down. Even in this case, if you need to place your pillow under your forehead, please do so. Gently relax your torso and bring your breath, your focus into your hip area. You will feel the stretching right there. Just a few more breaths into this static stretching. I really need you to relax. Relax your breath. Relax into the posture. This is pure Hatha Yoga, we can say. Bring your breath into your hips. The more you stay, the more you relax your lower spine and your inner thighs. Now from here, hold the posture. Just like you imagine to have a big tail and you want to move this tail left and right. You move your hips to the left, hips to the right. Remember, mobility toward flexibility. The more you move, the more flexible you become. But you have to be wide when you move. Keep your navel in and move the big tail side to side. Stop to the center. Imagine you want to rotate your tail, so you make big circle with your hips. Change direction. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Take the time, allow the time to your body to return to the original position. So we were basically reversing forward, but still the energy needs to return back. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Place your hands on the floor. Free your legs. We're gonna do a nice exercise for our toes. Make sure your hands are right beneath your shoulders, your elbows, the front of your elbows, the soft part, are turned forward. Take a deep breath in, navel is in. Curve your spine toward the floor. Feel the abdominal stretching. Exhale. Curve the spine toward the ceiling. I like to undulate back and forth to open a little bit more my lower spine. But if you don't feel comfortable, please don't do it. Inhale, curve back into cow pose. Note that my knees are separated, but my feet are touching. And then exhale, curve the spine into cat. Inhale. Don't go too fast in this posture. Enjoy the movement from one posture, cow, to cat posture. Feel the spine awakening into this posture. Feel your nervous system activating. This is dynamic stretching. Use your breath correctly. Inhaling, cow. Exhaling, cat. Inhale. Sit on your heel first, back, with your spine straight, palms facing up. So you relax the energy, you release the energy, you concentrate in your palms because you were holding the posture. You release, allow it to flow. Take a deep breath in. Challenging exercise is coming up. It's a static stretching. Gonna keep it 10 seconds because more is gonna be painful. Hands on the floor, tap your toes down, sit on your heels. Have the courage to really sit on your heels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Inhale, release, exhale. Shift your weight to one side and stretch your legs. And I want you to go all the way down to your spine. Take a deep breath in and exhale. Now right leg up, out, down, up, out, down, up, out, down. Sometimes I laugh when people try to stretch their legs sideways, but they cannot do this movement. Unlock your hips. differential first, and then you try any other thing. Bring your leg in, press it against the chest. I have slippery pants. Now, as you hold your foot here, your leg here, actually, hold your foot with your right hand. Lift your calf up and press your foot, your knee down. Is off baby pose, child pose. Feel the stretching inside. If it's more comfortable, you can bend the other leg. Relax. Take a moment and let's start the same work with the left leg. Up, out, down. Up, out, down. Up, out, down. Sometimes I have people telling me, oh, this is stretching. No. Is conscious movement. You are aware of what's happening in your body. These movements, this way to practice, will bring you back into the body. No out. You will feel high but grounded instead of to feel high and that's it. You will be present. Now push your knee back in, press, now, grab the inside of your foot and press the knee out. The knee has to go out. Balance. If you have issue with the balance still, hand on the floor. Legs are both straight. This is strengthening your shoulder, your arm, your wrist. Breathe. Take a deep breath in. You can go down to relax. Your hands and your arms, this is very important. Now, bend your right leg. If you are, of course, on your left side, if you are on your right side, then you have to bend your left leg and relax. This is ballet more than yoga. But it makes your legs very strong, your core very strong, and works on mobility to another different, complete level. See what I did here? Bend, stretch, lower. This is strengthening. Back to our mermaid posture with your hands right beneath your shoulders. This time you elongate only your left foot to the foot that or the leg that is below. Okay, the leg that is on top, you put it on the in the front. You open this knee very well. So there is a stretching in your hip area, and the exercise is the following. Inhale, using your navel, you stretch. Exhale. How much mobility there is here? Shoulder, hip, leg, arm. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale one more time. I like this posture. This is a Kuan Yin posture. Take a deep breath in and exhale. And inhale, change direction, hand underneath your shoulder, navel is in, legs in alignment. Change direction, right or left hand, depends on what side you are, on the floor, right beneath your shoulder. Leg straight, one on top of the other. The opposite arm is on top of your legs. Unless you need a balance, you touch the floor with your hands. Navel is in, you stretch the inside. You can be on your elbow if it's on your hand is too much. This is a very good stretching if you have issues or cramps in your hands. I like to look straight at a point in front of me. It stimulates my focus and concentration. Do not roll back here. Now the second version, stretch, lower. For the next movement, the challenging one. For the next movement, the challenging one. Back on your hands. Stretch your lower leg straight. Notice that my foot is flat and then the right is in the front. Back into poignant posture. One side might be slightly weaker than the other side. You can just do movement like this or lift just a little bit. Four times. Inhale. Like one yin for a moment. Open your knees. Close your eyes. And inhale. Back to the center. In the background. Take a deep breath in and exhale. We're gonna use this mantra Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Sa Swaha. It's the mantra from Four Tara, and you can decide to chant it or you just listen to it. It's incredibly healing and it turns the energy of your heart on, activating a natural healing chi within your body that will go and flow into every corner of your body. I will turn the volume up so you can hear it better. And as I said, you can chant it along, or you can decide to just listen to it and allow the energy of Tara, this cosmic star that balance and harmonize our chi, work on you. Okay, let this be your relaxation, and you can also lay down if you like, or you can meditate, but allow the energy to just flow and free itself for healing purposes. Relax your breath as well, and you can decide where to put your hands, here or here or here or here.
Jai 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 Jai
take a deep breath in and exhale. Inhale again and exhale. We are ready to close our class. If you are laying down, slowly move your body, take a deep breath in, and find a nice way to return into easy pose. We went a little bit over 1 hour, so it's time to close our class. I did a longer meditation than I had in mind. I just felt I needed it. But you know, you can cut it short if you feel it's better this way. I hope you rested on your spine if you decided to lay down. Let's close the class and let's refocus the energy so that you can start your day properly or finish your day properly. Take a deep breath in. Collect the energy all around you and recompact it, integrate it into the body. Inhale, we opened with the Kuan Yin energy and we close with Kuan Yin, the warrior goddess. Exhale. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Arms up, palms together. Bring the energy of the cosmic mother into your heart. Bow to the infinite blessing she will dispense you with. Root, anchor this creative energy into your boom, cosmic boom, or hara point, and rise your energy into your heart to seal the seed. And with gratitude, bow to the divine energy for the guidance, support, and protection during your practice. Thank you so much. I hope you liked this class. There were like a couple of exercises that were a little bit challenging, but I hope you feel good. You can always reach out to me and tell me how you're doing. And if you have any question about the practice, about each exercise or movement, please ask me. Do not hesitate. I will be happy to follow up with you and answer your questions. See you in the next class. We're gonna do one more class on mobility and flexibility, and this time I'm going to incorporate both upper and lower part of the body with some other exercises that we can do to make our body a little bit more receptive and more mobile and flexible, of course. See you in the next video. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye.